See your heart in everything you make. was a boat stuck in a bottle that never got the chance to touch the sea. Just forgot on the shelf, no wind in the sails, going nowhere with no one but me. I was one in 100 billion, a burnout star in a galaxy. Just lost in the sky, wondering why everyone else shines out for me. But I came to life when I first kissed you. The best me has his arms around you. Can make me better than I was before. Thank God I'm yours. I wasn't born out set of shoes, wandering the city streets. Another face in the crowd, head looking down, lost in the sound of a lonely melody. An empty pocket set of roulette, always landing on a lost bed. And just live for the spin, hope for the wind, go all in.
We're gathered together today to celebrate what God's put in the hearts of Taylor and Andrew and to witness their coming together as husband and wife today. As a symbol of love and blessing, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
Give her a hug and grab a seat. If you guys would face each other. If you join with me in prayer. Father, we thank you so much for this moment, this day. We thank you today, Father, that this is not just a formal ceremony that is man-made or man-created, but there's something very holy, something very special happening right now in this moment. And God, you are the author of marriage. You created, you designed marriage. And the reason that everybody's got the feels right now is because you're here and you know what you're doing and you're in the middle of this day. And Father, we ask you today that you would be with Andrew, that you would be with Taylor, and that you would not only prepare them for the ceremony of this day, but God, that you would prepare them for the lives that they'll share together. And we thank you today, Father, and we invite you to be the biggest part of this day. Let the power of your Spirit be in this ceremony, in this moment, and in the time we have together today. In Jesus' name, we ask it all. And everybody said, you can be seated. Weddings are really interesting. I have done a number of weddings myself and officiated a number of weddings, and I'm just pastor confession right now. They're not all fun. They're not all fun because some of them are just like cookie cutter. They're just normal, standard weddings. You go through the ceremony, and every now and again, you'll get a wedding ceremony where it feels a little different. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? It's like, wow, these people really love each other and they like really care about each other and they really want to do this. And there's something very special about this family. I know this side of the world a little bit better than I know Andrew's side of the world, mom and dad and Taylor. And I think there's something unique and holy going on today. It's not just a wedding ceremony. There's something God's doing. And I think it's incredible and awesome. And today with Andrew, I mean, what mom doesn't want their daughter to marry a son who's crying like one of the three guys in a Bachelor tell-all episode, right? Like, who doesn't want that? And in the middle of this moment, I don't know if you're feeling it. I don't know if you'll sense it today. I hope you do. This is not just two people making a commitment to one another. It's two people making a commitment to God before one another. And I think there's something really unique about this moment, really unique about this day. And I want to say this to the two of you. I think there's something really unique about this couple. I think the story to be told is going to be a beautiful story. And I think there's an incredible journey that you'll both share. And I think you're going to see God be incredibly faithful all along the way. Andrew, you're charged today for providing for your family and for caring for Taylor. As the head of your home, God entrusts you with the responsibilities of consideration and love towards your wife. You're to take care of her, to shelter her, to comfort her, and to strengthen her. To be understanding and sensitive to her needs, even when your flesh may not understand, to uplift her and to treasure her every day of your life. You're to love her selflessly as Jesus loves his church. And Taylor, you're charged with certain responsibilities towards Andrew as well. You're to take care of him, to support him in his successes and dreams, as well as his shortcomings. You're to trust him and to honor him in everything. Look to him for encouragement and security, being considerate to him always. be constant, consistent in your love, knowing that God brought this companion, the one that you prayed for. So never take him for granted, but instead value him more and more every single day of your lives. Andrew, do you take Taylor to be your wife? Do you commit yourself to her happiness, to her self-fulfillment as a person, to her usefulness in God's kingdom? Do you promise to love, honor, trust, and serve her, forsaking all others, accepting full responsibility for her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Andrew, if you would repeat after me. I, Andrew.
Take you, Taylor.
To be my lawfully wedded wife. I affirm my love to you. As my constant friend. My faithful partner. And my love from this day forward. Through kindness. Unselfishness. And trust. We will experience the fullness of God. And his will for our lives. And we will make our marriage. A ministry. I take you to be my wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward. In sickness and in health. In times of joy. And in times of sorrow. You're not expecting those? they're coming, bro. they're coming. I know it doesn't feel like it right now, but I promise to love you unconditionally. To support your dreams. To honor you. To respect you. To laugh with you. To cry with you. Trusting God in every situation. Giving our lives to him. Serving him. As long as he grants us life. Taylor, do you take this man to be your husband? Do you commit yourself to his happiness and to his self-fulfillment as a person and to his usefulness in God's kingdom? And do you promise to love, to honor, and trust and serve him, forsaking all others and accepting full responsibility for every need as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Taylor, if you would repeat after me. I, Taylor.
Take you, Andrew.
To be my lawfully wedded husband. I affirm my love to you. As my constant friend. My faithful partner. And my love from this day forward. Through kindness. Unselfishness. That too. And trust. To experience the fullness of God's will in our lives. And we'll make our marriage a ministry. I take you to be my husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. In sickness and in health. Times of joy and sorrow. She didn't struggle with that one. I'm just saying. I promise to love you unconditionally. To support you in your dreams. To honor you and respect you. To laugh with you. And to cry with you. To cherish you. Trusting God in every situation. Giving our lives to him. Serving him as long as he grants us life. The rings that you exchange today are not your marriage, and they just signify that you are married. And today, Andrew, if you would take the ring and repeat after me. Place it upon her finger. Taylor, with this ring. I thee wed. Wear it as a symbol. Of all we will share. We're going to leave that one alone. Taylor, if you would take the ring. Place it upon his finger. Repeat after me. Andrew, with this ring.
I thee wed.
Wear it as a symbol. Of all we shall share. That too. We're going to celebrate a moment of communion. It's a private moment for this couple. The very first thing that they'll do in their marriage is to bring Jesus right into the center of it. If you're not familiar with church, maybe you're not a churchgoer, it's all cool. The bread and the wine that they'll celebrate and they'll drink today represents the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. And as an act of worship, the very first thing they'll do today is invite Jesus into their lives, into their marriage, into this day. If you want to stay in an attitude of prayer and enjoy the moment with them, we're going to take a private moment and celebrate communion together. this girl's so openly spiritual. And you would discount and discredit yourself. You would just say, I'm just not that kind of guy. It's not who I am. It's not the person I am. But I believe God picked you for her because you're her spiritual equal. You're not less than. She's not going to be the driver of your family. You're going to be spiritual differently than her. But you're a spiritual person. You're feeling what you're feeling today, not because you're just getting married and it's an emotion. Like, this is God. What you're feeling today is God in the middle of everything that's going on. And so today, as you guys celebrate this moment, celebrate this time together, dude, you are the right guy for the right time that God chose for this moment. To be with her, to lead her, to guide her, to be everything she needs for you to be. Your prayers might be shorter, and you might feel like, I just don't have it. But you do, bro, you do. You have everything she needs for you to be everything you need to be. To step in. There are going to be times where she's overwhelmed, and you're the guy who's going to say, let's pray. There are going to be times where she's not going to know what to do, and you're going to be the guy who says, let's pray. And there are going to be times where she's going to say, what's next? And you're going to be the guy that's going to say, I think God told me. And you're going to have words, man, words for your family, words for your future. I'm going to pray for you guys. And is that cool? Father, in Jesus' name, I declare today that this is your doing. They didn't find each other. You found them for one another. And we thank you today, Father, that you are so good in everything that you do in our lives. You are so faithful in everything that you do in our lives. God, I declare blessing over them today. God, they're going to live in the land of plenty and not lack. They're going to live in the land of more than enough. They're going to have more than enough time, more than enough money, more than enough resource, more than enough energy, more than enough passion. Father, I thank you today that they're not going to be walking and wondering what you're up to in their lives, but their lives are going to be a great adventure where they're going to follow you. And God, there'll be some ups and there'll be some downs, but even the downs, they're going to feel you so in them that even the downs are going to feel okay. They know they're going to be okay. And God, I pray today that not only would this couple be a blessing to each other, but you would use them as a trophy couple for other couples to look at and say, that's it. That's it. That's the life that I want. Father, they probably have friends right now today that are looking at them saying, man, I just don't know if I can live that way. I don't know if I can do that. But God, even this moment right now, family and friends are watching them saying, that's what I want. That's what I want my life to be like. And Father, we declare today that you're here. You're up to good things. You're doing good things. And you're going to bless them in everything they put their hands to do in Jesus' name.
Overflowing this place.
You good?
Fill our hearts with your love. Your love surrounds us. You're the reason we came to encounter your love. Your love surrounds us.
Today, you've joined your hearts and your lives together in a marriage that will be Christ-centered. You've made a covenant with one another and symbolized the joining of hands and the sharing of vows and exchange of rings by the authority vested in me, the Commonwealth of Virginia, but way more importantly, the gospel of Jesus Christ. I now pronounce you man and wife. Hold up, bro. I got to say it first. Do it, man. But don't go anywhere. Ladies and gentlemen, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Andrew Grubbs.